I'm going to guess that you're clearly a healthy guy, that you don't smoke.
I do not smoke, and that's a constant battle with my patients to try and get patients to smoke.
And it really is for a lot of people, but maybe you have a loved one that you're trying to convince to stop smoking. Maybe nothing's worked. Well, this viral video could help. Check out this experiment done by a YouTuber named Chris Notap. He used tubing and a jar filled with cotton balls to mimic the effect smoking an entire pack of cigarettes has on the lungs and throat. After 20 cigarettes are smoked through the makeshift lungs, cotton balls are left a gross brown color from the toxic chemicals. The clip also shows the pump's tube, which presents the represents the throat, clogged with a sticky brown gooey tar. Because we know sometimes you can tell people, look, it's gonna cause early death, it's gonna cause lung cancer, it's gonna cause COPD. But sometimes you just need a visual.
Yes.
Absolutely.
That visual, it is, right? It's shocking. Yeah. And to think that's your lungs, I think it works,
yeah.
These visuals.
Yeah, I mean, that's 20 cigarettes, too. And I think people, the danger of this is not to be understated. It is the leading cause of preventable death. It's almost 500,000 people die of this every year, which is more than combined HIV, alcohol abuse, illegal drugs, car accidents. This is something you can intervene if you have a loved one who smokes.
Since people often don't think about what's going on inside of the body, we gotta remember the organ affected directly from that smoke is your lungs. And this is the lung of a 70-year-old gentleman who smoked a pack a day, ended up having COPD, AKA emphysema. And we see this a lot oftentimes with emphysema where you end up with severe air trapping. Thank you very much. This lung is a lot larger than you would expect. And what happens in emphysema is those air spaces get destroyed slowly over time. Air and oxygen exchange, CO2 exchange is compromised. You've all seen it, someone just gasping for breath. And so every time you smoke a cigarette, you have to ask yourself if it's worth the potential agony of years and years of shortness of breath. And just remember what that's doing to your organs. Remember what it's doing to your heart. Remember what it's doing to your lungs. And that may be just enough motivation to try to quit. And if you try to quit and it doesn't work, you know this, doc.
You go see your family doctor, your primary care doctor, have that conversation.
Yes.
Because that is the step one to solving this issue. Absolutely.
I'm curious, nowadays, as a family practice doctor, so much of it is focused on prevention. Are these the kinds of things where you feel like it's become more emphasized in your training?
Absolutely, and not only in my training, where it's being emphasized is in the health records. Because we're switching over from paper charts to electronic health records, now the computer forces you to have the conversation, if you forget, about smoking.
Wow.
So every patient
you
that comes
to
my
door,
you can't continue on in the section, exactly. And you look at this video, what this video tells me, not only as you could tell how disgusting it is, but it shows that the effects of smoking are actually you could touch them, you can see it. So if you smoke, and then you smoke outside, you think you're going inside, you're not affecting your family, you have to think twice, because there's something called third-hand smoking, which most people aren't aware of, where the tobacco smoke, the nicotine, lives on your skin, on your clothes, that when you go back, you play with your kids, you can raise the chances of certain illnesses, certain allergies being developed, and that's something we've never thought about before, but with videos like this, we can clearly visualize.
Yeah, just remember, if you smoke and you've tried to quit before, it's never too late. I do want to thank Research for Life for loaning us these lungs. And in that same vein, a thank you to anyone who's ever donated their organs to medical science.